Edvard Grieg was a great personality who made the music and the landscapes of Norway known all over the world. His most famous music is the one he wrote for Ibsen's play Peer Gynt. But many, many other pieces are also well known. I will play for you now one piece here in the middle of this rather wild fjord, a piece dealing about Norwegian trolls. We have many of those in all kinds. And sometimes I say, in a way, Edvard Grieg himself was a troll, because he was only 150 tall. And also his wife, Nina, was a small woman. And sometimes Nina's sister came to Bergen to live with them. And then there were three small people. So when they went for their Sunday morning walk, the neighbors would say, the trolls are coming. So I pay for you the March of the Trolls. We are many tourists here today on this ship, but in fact I can tell you, Edvard Grieg was one of the very first tourists in Norway. He was born in 1843, and when he got grown up, he would like to go to the fjords and to the mountains every summer to experience this fabulous nature that we can see around us now. This nature was always a big source of inspiration. And when walking like this, together with one or two friends maybe, in the mountains, Edvard Grieg would meet also the Norwegian folk music in its original form. He would meet people who were working in the mountains, looking after the cows and sheep, who would sing for him melodies. And also he would meet people playing the national Norwegian hardanger fiddle. And these tunes also Grieg enjoyed very much. I will now play a piece very much inspired by the Norwegian folk music. But this piece is Edvard Grieg's own melody. It is called The Bridal Procession Passes By. As the last piece of this little recital, I will play for you Grieg's own arrangement of one of the old Norwegian hardanger fiddle tunes. These tunes became famous because they were so modern for its time. And when played in Paris for the first time in the beginning of the 20th century, people said this is Le Nouveau Grieg, which means the new Grieg. Because here Grieg develops a way of writing for the piano, very modern. Many composers came to Paris at this time, for example, Maurice Ravel and Béla Bartók, to learn about music. And we are quite sure they heard Edvard Grieg's Norwegian peasant dances. What concerns Béla Bartók, he came to Norway like you. He took the boat from Bergen up to Kirkenes, and back home to his homeland, he brought a national Norwegian Hardanger fiddle. You can find it on the wall in his museum. I'm sure you can see some and hear some similarities between this music and the music of Béla Bartók. There is a little anecdote connected to this piece that I'm going to play now. There was a man called Knut, and Knut, he enjoyed very much to dance. He would always be the best dancer. But also, he enjoyed very much to fight, and he would always be the strongest person. Finally, the people had enough of him, so they sent for the new priest, because they knew he was a strong man as well. And then, this time, Knut was thrown out, and not only the man, but the door blade and the framework of the door went into the yard. So, Rutnam's Knut.
Thank you. On the port side, about 300 meters up in the mountainside,